What is going on, peeps? YouTube familia? I want to fix this XDK. So, we're going to try following this simple little guide on how to reflash the sidecar. Hopefully it'll work. I guess there's a few things I need to get in order to do it. Hey, Oz. So let's see. What's up, Corey? Doing awesome. How are you doing? All right, let's see. So we need the Xbox 360 command prompt SDK tool. Jason Schnookums. Yeah, a little bit. Development computer dev kit mode. I don't know where those are. The Xbox 360 command prompt SDK tool. Not sure where that is. Yeah. Xbox 360 command prompt SDK tool. Okay, installing the XDK in DevKit OS. That's Xbox One. Xbox 360 XDK tools. Not sure where you get that from. I'm looking for the XDK command prompt tool, and I don't see where you can get it from. Yeah, MacBooks suck. Xbox 360 dev kit tools. What the hell? Wonderful. So you can't download it unless you're like a member of that. So shit, where am I gonna find it? This guide says that I need to launch the Xbox 360 Command Prompt SDK tool. And I have no effing clue where I can get that from, so maybe I won't be able to fix this. Xbox 360 Command Prompt Tools. Well, megabyte. Well, I don't even know what version of Xbox this XDK is. Let's see. It is a. It's a Zephyr. That's weird. Not sure if this is it or not, but we'll see. Well, we'll try that. Let's see if it works. I don't think it will. That guide is not very. That's huge. We can try that. What's up, Joseph the Lurker? All right, well, I'm downloading a couple different things. Xbox 360 SDK kit, which is like a gigabyte. It's going to take a little while to download. And then the other one is the XDK setup. Which is also going to take a little bit of time. So, while we're waiting, let's play with our cocks. Here's a Cock 01 board, AO1. While we're waiting, this is another one that Ruben sent me. He also sent it with no fan. Who knows what's going on with this one? How was it supposed to feel? Let's guess, since this one has bubbly tokens, or that little heat sticker that's on top of the tokens is bubbly, I'm assuming that he probably did the same thing with this one, which is tried to reflow it with the heat gun and failed miserably. You don't have to. You don't have to. This one doesn't look like it was blasted with heat quite as much because it's not discolored. So let me get a fan. Oh no, this one's too short. Gosh darn it. Little turd. Yeah, it's one way to get Felix to pay attention. Pull your cock out. Felix, I love the cock. The cock. Hey, Victor. Yeah, it started not too long ago. Ah. It's 2022. $3,001 of those tokens. I wish I knew all the error codes. I know 3034. Trying to fall asleep. Oh, you should fall asleep if you need to. What do we got, Felix? What do we got, Vic? Maybe. I haven't tried turning this one on. What's 2022? Get out of here, Naked Headquarters, HD. Ban them, Nightbot. A short and 12 volt? That would be a fun fix. All right, Vic, let's check. Is Count Vicula correct? There's no short in 12 volt. Well, at least not on the connector. The connector's good. Maybe the power the maybe the power supply was dead. Oh, wrong one. My bad. It's booting up. It's there was 2022. Looks like we might get green light of death. I don't know if it's displaying anything. It's not displaying anything right now. Yeah, 3001 2022. About to overheat. It stayed on though. Let me get the AV cords. Try that. Yeah, I don't know. I haven't taken the motherboard out yet. Signal on AV or HDMI. The step number. Gosh darn it. Ah, that makes sense because it wasn't displaying anything. Yeah, delidded. Both have been delidded. Well, I was going to do the SDK, but he's missing a thermal pad on the... What the hell is this? Weird. Alright, well. Nice D-lid. It looks like the entire Blu-ray circuit is removed over here for the Blu-ray drive. Doesn't look like it was reflowed though. But boink boink. I mean, is that gonna cause 2022? I don't think so. It looks like the entire Blu-ray drive area over here is removed. That's all the components in the Blu-ray drive voltage, but that shouldn't cause the 2022, I don't think, because we had that other one that was working. reflow the HDMI port. Can the RSX cause 2022? What do we start with, guys? You want to check the mislines? Shall we check the miscellaneous lines on the front?
Swear I won't forget this. Why do I regret this? In my mind reckless, thoughts are feeling endless. Sitting up, I'm breathless. Anxiety's infectious. I feel so defenseless, betrayed and embarrassed. I hate being angry. I hate being broken. I feel like an ocean filled up with emotion. Anger ain't a potion. Rub it on like lotion. I can feel it soaking. Reopen, the scars have awoken. I can't move on till I let go. I feel so lost, never at home. Need to be strong, every breath hold. Cause I can't move on till I let go. I can't move on till I let go. I feel so lost, never at home. Need to be strong, every breath hold. Cause I can't move on till I let go.
I don't think there's any point of repopulating the Blu-ray stuff, personally. It's not going to make any difference.
Always fight, never quit, do it right, play the game, win it life, have no shame, there's no time for the pain, let the grind, make a change. lane, commit and climb, the only way to win in life. I never miss that fact, taking big swings, bitch, hand me the bat. Put me in the ring, you'll go out in a bag, cause I sing what I mean and I bring it to the mat. Time to kill, I got time to fail, I took the red pill. I know life's short, so I wanna live real, but how's it? What's up, Ruben? Working on another one of your cocks. Well, yeah, it doesn't, because the other one that we fixed, Ruben, he sent us one, and it was bad, and it was not causing the DVE error. So, another one that you sent that was just the motherboard in the frame, it didn't have any components. This one's not getting any display. No output in any of the display. Yeah, definitely good delids on these for sure. Where's my parts board? Not really a green light of death, it's more like no video of death. Yeah, it's very possible. I don't see any other issues on this board though, so. Besides the Blu-ray drive components missing. Thank you.
You talking about the one in the corner over here, this DVIC, this one? VDDQ is all right. VDDIO looks good. YCRC is good. VDDA good. A little low actually, 3.8. Ah, there we go. 4. VDDR 400 ohms. VDC is good at 2.6, and the cell's at 2. So yeah, those are all decent. Filters are good. Hey Mike. The deal is with this being on there. Get a dual pad on the south bridge. Can we find where the, Hey, shitbrick lover. No, I'm not padding it. There was two pads on top of the south bridge. So that was causing the board to be lifted on that one area, which is not good. And this one's got green light of death, as far as we can tell. Where do we check for the miscellaneous voltages? Now I forget the schematic. I don't know it off the top of my head except for looking at the schematics, but oh, okay. I can check that, yeah. Oh, I can get there. Let me see here. Misleading stream title today since I'm not working on a 360, but hey. See repairs, backwards compatible, Felix Book of Knowledge, Pandora's Box, he said Topology, Power Control Topology 2. Boom. Alright. Yeah, I don't know, Jerry. I got everyone and their mom sending them to me nowadays. Hey, Robert. Doing good. How are you? You didn't miss it because I didn't start it. I didn't know that I needed to find the SDK software for the command prompt. And I didn't have that, nor did I know where to find it. So I downloaded a few things, haven't installed them yet. All right, let's see. Music and miscellaneous voltage. So this is a cock, yes. Let's see, 5 volt USB will be right here. We got 5 volt. Let's do 5 volt miscellaneous to the left of it, right here. We got that. 3.3 miscellaneous, which is gonna be right here. We got that. 5 volt for the hard drive here. Got that. Anna and 3.3 Anna are present. 9 volt Anna should also be present. Actually, yep, that's present. Oh, it's raining, huh? Well, except for the Blu-ray, which we're probably not gonna have, because it doesn't have 5 volts there. Someone's calling me. Huh. Yeah, definitely not. Well, I see all of the voltages are present, so this might actually be a bad RSX. Let's see, this would, if this wasn't here, 3.3 ever, if that wasn't there, then it wouldn't get the other miscellaneous voltages. What's the word of caution? The power supply overheating? Oh, definitely green light of death, because it's stuck on. It won't power off properly. So it's definitely a green light of death. So this one needs a reball. This one needs another RSX. Green Light of Death could be CPU related, yeah. Yeah, absolutely, Felix. yeah, this one's not. This is a Green Light of Death. So this one would need a reball, which I'm not going to do right now. I'm going to see if I can go back to the XDK stuff for now, because I don't know how much longer I'm going to be staying here tonight. Might go hang out with a few friends. Nah, I don't want to do a dirty reflow tonight. Like I said, I don't know how much longer I'll be staying here. I have a friend that invited me over this weekend, and I didn't make it there yesterday, and I was thinking of going over there today. We'll see. I'm probably going to leave, though, not too soon. Maybe like an hour or so. I do want to check out this XDK. See if I can reflash it. I just wanted to take a peek at this PS3 while I was waiting for that stuff to download. I didn't want to dive all the way into these PS3s right now. Just wanted to see what this one was doing, but this one's Green Light of Death. No, it's a bunch of my guy friends. If it were a chick, Travis, I probably wouldn't be here, bro. If there was somebody that I was interested in, I'd probably be spending time with them on the weekend. Not gonna lie. Oop, what was that? Oh. Light of nightmares. The green light of nightmares. So this 360 that I reflowed, I ran it for literally 3 days straight. So that's like 20 something hours at least, because it's about 8 hours of time. So 16, 25 hours or so, it's running great. Great. I don't care, Travis. one way or the other. Phil's awesome. He's a great supporter. And he does crazy shit too, so he's fun to watch. Alright, let's see about this XDK software that I downloaded. But Booter! Sure you do, Trav. What's up, Light? So, yeah, I already looked at this. I didn't really know what to do. Oh, I didn't know there were links here. Actually I did. So yeah, I don't know at this point what the hell I just installed. Where is it at? Console companion? No, that's not it. I don't know where the command prompt is. Well, let's get the console out and see. Thank you. Xbox Neighborhood. Yeah, I don't see that. I'll check the program files. You're saying for the neighborhood program? I don't think that one was plugged in. Was it? No, I don't think it was. Wait. Yeah, it was. Hold on. No. Ha. So you're saying Xbox Neighborhood you think is going to be in the C drive? I don't think there is that there, but let's try it. SDK. Yeah, no, I don't see the neighborhood. have this Microsoft Xbox SDK, and then it has all this stuff: audio console, API monitor, preview, pipeline animator, profile viewer, effect font maker, game disk emulator, cross-platform, net growth, packet analysis, SDK documentation, visual gesture builder. Oh, there it is, command prompt. All right. There we go, that's what I needed. So this tells us to launch the 360 command prompt SDK tool. Set your Xbox as the default console in SDK, which I don't really have. Let me get my power cord, if I can find it. Here it is. Let's make sure the damn thing still launches. So it's turning on. As we can see up here, it is on. Let's see if it actually boots. So it doesn't want to boot if I plug this thing in the side. Unplug that. Try turning it on without that plugged in. I'm just trying to get the hard drive and DVD drive to work on this console, because the DVD drive does not work unless you flash the, I guess, flash the sidecar, which is the extra piece for the dev kit 360. Like, the DVD drive doesn't even eject. I think I have it plugged in wrong. Oh, no, I don't. Okay. So we have it up and running. Let me grab a. Let me grab a cable. Okay. Plug this cable into the PC. Let's see, what is this thing? Whoops, what is this thing? DVD MU. Bam, DVD MU. Okay, so goes to here. Okay, we got it plugged into the DVD MU of the PC. Then type xdk/i bang 0. XKD. /i 0. Okay. FPGA firmware for selected console requires an update to use the debugging feature. The process takes about 2 minutes and power cycles the console. Yes. All right, so now it is flashing the firmware of the sidecar. And this console should restart when it's done. And then it should eject and should work. Because right now it's not ejecting. See that? It says boot or dev in the bottom. See that on the bottom? Boot or dev. Oh, nice, Kyle. Yeah, I don't know what's up with this thing, why, but apparently, like, the flash banks or whatever for the firmware go bad on the sidecar. I don't know how that happens, but then it doesn't work properly, the dev kit. I don't get it. I would assume that, I don't know. I don't even know if this is going to work or not. It is flashing the FPGA firmware, but we'll see if it works. Oh snap, it's done downloading 700 gigabytes worth of Xbox games from my Xbox, so now we just gotta go to the second set. G games. Wait, what? Let me see. Oh, let me see. Where did I download them from? Moms Galore. Xbox games. Okay, so now we gotta go to the G drive, go games, and do all of these. Download. Oh boy, that's gonna take some time. It's gonna take some time. Now I'm downloading the second set of ROMs that I have on there. Okay, and it just restarted the console. Oh, nice, Kyle. That's awesome. All right, does it eject? Woo! It ejects now. Fuck yes. All right. So, it ejects now. Check it. Whee! It didn't used to eject. Now it does. So, I guess I'm gonna turn this thing off. Turn this thing off. Okay. And then we're gonna unplug the power. And we're gonna unplug the XDK from the PC, or the sidecar that is. Then we're gonna plop this hard drive back in, see what the hell happens. See if it recognizes it. Okay. Plug this stupid little connector in. This connector goes in both ways. I'm not sure exactly which way it's supposed to go in, but I guess we'll figure that out in a second here. Okay, let's turn it back on and see if it'll recognize this hard drive. See what happens. Is it going to give me an error? Like it might be erroring. It's having a sweet hard time turning on, that's for sure. Oh, it turned on. Sick. Okay. So let's sync this controller. Okay, and let's go to tools. Actually, let's launch the dashboard. See if it has. Ooh, it finds the hard drive now. All right, that is cool. Okay. Does that mean I can put whatever size hard drive I want in here? Because 100 gigs is pretty small. Let's put a game in and see if it reads the game. Do I have a 360 game in my pile over here? Let's see. I have original Xbox game. Will that work? Splinter Cell. Let's see what happens. I love the blades. It looks so awesome. Is reading, but it's not quite getting there. Let me get a 360 game. I hope it reads games. Unplayable disc. That's cool. Either the laser's bad or this, it doesn't read Xbox games, who knows. Doesn't seem like it's reading. Can you not play original games on this thing? I'm sure you can. Oh. It does say that. It says, these consoles are incapable of playing retail games and can only launch development signed execs files. Yeah. No, no, the drive was empty, but, yeah, so apparently the dev kits cannot play. Is there anything I can download to verify that the drive works? Like, is there anything I can download to put in this drive? Like, all right, well, if it can't even play games, I know it's a development kit, but what the hell can I even do with the damn thing besides sell it, like, to somebody who wants a dev kit? Like, what the hell's the point of the damn thing? If I can't even play a game on it, what the heck can I do on it? Nothing. But at least it works now, so I can slap it back together and it'll look pretty. It looked pretty cool. Did I repaste this thing? I don't think I did. I should at least do that. Is there something I can download, like an XDK ISO or something like that? Yeah, I get it. Let's see. I'm trying to look for like a game, like 360 XDK game download. I don't know. Let's see. Can I unplayable disc? There's no disc in there, dude. Won't read the USB stick. Am I asking for what? What's up, Weasel? Alright, now I gotta figure out how to put this damn thing back together. Pretty sure all of these things go for this, and all the rest of the stuff that's for the XDK sidecar, all of this stuff goes there. Let's see, how am I gonna do this? And also, is this one gonna work? I don't know what happened to the original. Oh, you know what? It was frayed, I think. So I threw it away. No problem. Alright. So this, for sure, goes here. But what about... I would assume that... This is gonna go this way. So I would assume that these go here. And then this goes on top of here. These probably go here. I don't remember which way this thing actually went together, so. Pretty sure this way, but. Alright, and then this little doodad plugs up this. Oh, that's not gonna work. I need to... Okay, that's not gonna work. Let's go. Alright, so let's take this thing back off if I can. Don't break. How was that? Okay. I think that I need a right angle one for that. So let's do this one. Alright, I guess that looks right. I am not opening this thing back up once I put it back together. And I kind of want to sell it now that he can't do a damn thing with it. It's the Transformer Edition XDK. Hey Jason, is that where you post your pictures? Stop spamming your links there, Jason. We don't want to see your naked HD pics. Travis, what are you doing on those links? I didn't know you were hot for Jason like that, Trav. Alright, well, I hope this is gonna work. Hope that's enough slack on all of these. Guess we'll find out, huh? That is a huge damn cable. Find out. Otherwise, I have to take this whole thing apart again. I guess I could feed it all through here just to make sure that it fits before I finish this up. This stupid design. Shit, I think I have it backwards. I think this needs to go the other way, because don't the ports for the SDK things go out the back end? Don't they? Or is it the front? Because, like, the USB ports are on the front here. I don't know if they're supposed to face the rear or the front. Damn. Probably the rear. This is a pain in the ass. I need to go back and look at the video though and see which way they're supposed to go. Wow, this sucks. A picture of the XDK kit. Apparently I don't. I wonder if it matters. Darn, when did I get that 360 dev kit? When did I have that on the video? Didn't even label it. March 25th. That's true. Yeah, it's definitely on the back. I think the cables are going to be long enough. I just don't like this one cable as much too long. But yeah, it goes this way. I know it would be easier. Probably take the board out, repaste it. It's got the bolt mod? No, it's not the bolt mod. I don't even really need to repaste it because I'm not really going to be using it. It's just going to look pretty, but it works. There's nothing I can do on it. I don't develop. But it would be easier to take the motherboard out than to feed them through this little tiny little hole right here. This is gonna be fun. What a pain in the butt. Yeah, it's basically the regular cage because he lost parts of the cage or broke them, and I was able to replace them with an original 360 cage. The sidecar is a little damaged too, but that's okay. The casing, at least, the clips that hold it into the main shell are a little bit damaged. See if the thing still works and all the cables fit. Let's see if this is gonna work. This one goes here. No. This one. This one goes here. It's the shortest one. Goes here. Okay. This little tiny dude goes here. This one goes into the DVD drive. Or no. This one is supposed to go here. That. This one goes into the board, which is here. All right, let's see if the damn thing still works. Okay. DVD drive is opening. It has booted. Sees the hard drive, and it still tries to read games, even though it won't read them, it still tries to. Oh, what the fuck? It actually launched it. Why did it launch it that time? Okay, it actually said to play this disc, put it in a 360 console. But it actually launched it that time. So, that was kind of a cool little boot logo. Watch it do this little thing. Watch it do this. Oh no, it did a little boot logo before. It did like a little thingamajiggerbobber. Did like a 360 boot screen thingy. But it's not doing it this time. But at least we know that it's working. So, that's good. Okay. Now, can I get it back in here? That's the question. Can I get it back into its sidecar top thing without losing this pin? We'll see. Maybe I can tape it from the outside. That's what I'll do. Put a piece of tape on the outside here. Perfect. Okay. Great. Let's put this down here. This down in there. Wait, no, that goes on last because I gotta put the screws in. Okay. Yeah, it's just a YouTube audio library because I have been getting more. Last couple of videos I did got copyright strikes because I played just YouTube videos. And I didn't like that very much. Yeah, this stuff is safe to use because it's from the audio library. I don't really care that much, but... That's everything. Yeah, the clips are damaged on it, so it's not going to clip in, but... Sucks. Darn it, and there's also... I thought there was like a little piece of plastic, but I hear a little piece of plastic stuck in there somewhere. There it goes. Okay. Sweet. Whew. All right. Holy smokes. That was a pain. Alright, this fat beast is back together. Transformers. Alright, let's see if it still turns on. And everything works. Does it eject? Yes, it does. Yeah, the front looks cool. I like the Transformers front. It boots. Let's go ahead and tape her down. Okay. Let's put a disc in, see if we can get that boot animation to go one more time. Yeah, it does this little... Nope, it didn't do it that time, but it does this little like animation it did last time. Better one. I'm just putting tape on it for now. I don't feel like doing anything different with it. I don't want to glue or anything. Alright, turn it off. Alright. She's back in action. One more time. Alright, that's all the 360 XDK wrote for today. And that'll go in our case somewhere special. I don't think Felix is interested. I just put it back together and I reflashed the FPGA or whatever. Yeah, you did miss it because I just put it away. Well, I just put it to the side. But yeah, I just reflashed it and now it ejects and reads games and finds the hard drive. It did. Yes, yeah, Sean, it did. So I did not know that it doesn't play regular games though. So to me, it's pretty much worthless. Because if I wanted to play games on the XDK, I can't even do it. Because it only plays unsigned stuff, which is stupid, but I get it, I guess. I'm not sure where these four screws came from. I might not have put that thing fully back together. Did this come from the XDK? No, I don't think it did. Oh, this came from my Xbox hard drive. Okay, my original. That's right. Alright, dev kit power supply, that can go over with it. And I got the OG Xbox yesterday, or was it yesterday that I was having problems with it? It would like freeze downloading games. Well, I put it aside and then I came back today, plugged it in, and it's working great. Like, it's downloading all the games. I downloaded everything. Ha! That's pretty funny, Felix. I'll be right back. I'm gonna go to the bathroom. I'm a bidet. Booter XDK bidet. That's funny. Well, at least it works again. I rescued it from a saboteur. freaking damn near destroyed it. Luckily, he didn't get too far into it and didn't destroy any of the cables. And I mean, I guess even if he did, it might still have been recoverable. And this has got about 60 gigs left to transfer. That's a boatload of games. Let's see here. Boing. So I ordered 4 Xbox HDMI Plus, which are back ordered right now, but I ordered them from I ordered them from Make Megahertz. So I'm gonna be modding the Xbox that I modded with the 2 terabyte drive and SirBio. So I'm gonna put the Xbox HDMI in it. And I bought a few extras just because I wanna do that to a few. I wanna get my practice up. Haha, yeah, it's definitely a difficult one. But I wanna get my store stocked up with original Xboxes with the Xbox HDMI mods, because those are really cool. I have a few more Dreamcast HDMI mods that I need to do as well. But I think I'm going to go ahead and call it a night. Wasn't that long of a stream like my usual ones, but I'm going to go hang out with some friends for a little bit and then go home early so that I'm not up till 3 in the morning because I got work tomorrow. Get some food too. Yeah. Don't get molested. Yeah, don't want that. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. Been fun hanging with you all. Thank you for the support. Hit that like button. I'll be back hopefully next week. I'm not sure if I'll be doing my own stuff or customer repairs. I guess we'll find out next week. Tomorrow, that is. See what happens. And for the time being, see you guys next time. The next booter stream. Same booter cave, same booter channel. Yeah, next week is tomorrow. Booter out, that's right. Yeah, see you guys. Thank you so much for hanging out. It was fun, and we'll do it again. Adios, amigos.